In the last section of the series on the economic problem, I wanted to briefly discuss the types of economies that exist and the ones that the rest of the series will be based on. Throughout history, two main types of economies have emerged as viable options for organizing a nation's resources. The first type of economy is one which is centrally planned. This means that an institution such as a government will answer the three basic economic questions we have seen in a previous video. What to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce is all decided by the government. Free markets are also known as decentralized markets. This means that no one person or institution runs the entire economy. Prices and quantities of all goods in the economy are determined by the market forces of supply and demand, which we will explore in the next series. Historical evidence suggests that central planning does not work very well in the long run because the central planners don't know people's production possibilities and their preferences. Thus, resources are misallocated and the economy ends up producing at a point inside the PPF. Additionally, centrally planned economies ignore the concept of incentives. Thus, any firm within the economy would not be functioning as efficiently as possible. There would be no incentive to become more efficient in producing a given good. Thus, old and outdated methods of production would continue to be used. This is only one example of the inefficiencies caused by a lack of incentives. For decentralized markets to work, we need four things to be in place. A firm is an economic unit that hires factors of production and organizes them to produce and sell goods and services. A market is some arrangement that allows buyers and sellers of goods to get information and to do business with each other. This doesn't have to be a physical place, just some arrangement. Amazon is an example of a marketplace that does not have a physical location. The website allows buyers and sellers from around the world to connect with each other. Markets, however, can only work when property rights exist. Property rights are the social arrangements that govern the ownership, use, and disposal of anything that people value. The term real property rights refers to rights of ownership to land, building, machinery. Financial property includes stocks, bonds, and money in the bank. Intellectual property refers to the intangible product of creative effort. This property includes music, books, inventions, etc. Property rights is an incentive to innovate. Financial gain is the reward for those who choose to innovate. If property rights didn't exist, and people could simply steal property, then financial resources would be diverted to protecting people's property rather than innovation. Money is a commodity or a token that is uniformly accepted as a method of payment. The circular flow model is a highly simplified model of the free market economy, but illustrates the basic idea of how the economy works. In this model, we are going to assume that there is no government and that there is no international trade either. The first main entity in our economy is households. This consists of the general population. The second main entity in our economy is firms. We also have goods markets. This is simply the marketplace where goods and services are traded between buyers and sellers. It is not an entity like a household or a firm. Factor markets are similar to the goods markets in that they allow buyers and sellers to trade, but in this case, we are not trading goods or services. We are trading the factors of land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship on these markets. The circular flow works like this. Households spend money in the goods market. This money goes straight to firms, as firms are the sellers of these goods. Households, in return for their spent money, get some good or service. This good or service comes directly from the firm. The firm offers goods, and the households buy the goods. In order to produce the goods, the firm needs to buy resources from the factor markets. It is households that provide the resources of land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship. The firm must buy these resources from the factor markets, so it spends its money over there. At the end of the day, households are selling the factors of production, so the money goes back to them. From the diagram, it is clear that money simply flows from households and firms through the goods and factor markets. Goods and services flow from the firm to the household through the goods market, and economic resources flow from households to firms in factor markets.